Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel CrackGate Online. In this video, I will be dealing with the bending force on the implement. So, as you can see in this picture, when implement goes into any field, then various type of forces act on this implement, such as the weight of the implement, such as the side draft and the bending and many other forces. So, in this particular video, I will be dealing only about the bending force. Okay, so let's start. This video will be presented by me. You can see more details here. So before going into the discussion, let's see some past year statistics. So this is the question coming from the implement section. This implement is only about the primary and secondary tillage implements, and these questions is specifically related to the forces acting on these. And in 2014, you can also see this question was related to field efficiency. Means in 2014 there was no question which was particularly related to the implement forces. So with this table, I just want to say, if you are not able to solve this type of questions, because these questions are quite typical and you need to visualize the entire situation, you need to understand where these forces are acting and how to proceed. So even if you are not able to solve these questions, so don't take too much tension, especially the fourth year students who are going to appear just in this February exam. So you can see the statistics. In this video, I will be dealing about this 30 number question of 2017, and one question I will give you for practice. So let's start. So here we will see some theoretical concepts, and later we will solve one problem. So here, as on screen you can see, this is a cultivator. Suppose this cultivator is going into field and one bending force will act on here. So where this bending force will act? Suppose the bending force is acting at working height of H. This H is the depth at which bending force is acting. And what is this F? This F is the draft force which this implement is encountering. So this much resistance, this much draft is offered to this implement by the soil. Okay, so if this is the draft force and this is your sank, so you now see the cross section area. What is the cross section area if you will see for this sank? So this and this. So if you will draw this cross section, you will look like this. Okay, as shown in here. So what will be the this? This is the thickness of your sank, and this is the width of your sank. Okay, so this is width and this is the thickness. So here, what is B? B is the thickness and D is the width or depth. Okay, so now see the formula, how you will calculate this B and value of D. So you have to remember this general equation. You can remember like sigma by y equal to m by I. What is this m, I, y and sigma? So this m is the movement of, what is the movement this implement is getting because of this draft force. So this will become equal to F into H. This I is the movement of inertia of this particular section. Whatever section I showed you, you can see it here. So how to calculate this I? This I will be equal to BDQ by 12, where B is your thickness. This B is your thickness of sank and D is your depth. Okay, so this value will be BDQ by 12. This Y will be equal to, this is the distance of natural axis. Okay, so this will be equal to D by 2. And value of sigma is, bending strength. So you need to remember this general equation and how to calculate these various parameters. Based on that, you can solve this question. So let's move ahead towards the 2017 question. Okay, so you pause the video and read this question first. So here information has been given as a vertical distance where it is acting is 450 mm. This 400 is not required. This 400 value will be not used for calculating anywhere. So let's first see, this is your subsoiler. So what will be the cross section of this subsoiler? As you can see, this will be your depth and this will be your width. So what cross section you will get? You will get cross section like this, where this will be your thickness. You can use your own anything to denote. If you want to denote thickness by T, that you can also do. And this is your depth. So this will become your cross section. So now what more information has been given? Power has been given, speed has been given. So from there you can calculate the draft force. Now you know the draft. So how to calculate the bending moment? By distance you know where this force is acting. So this force is acting at 450 mm depth. So moment will be equal to this draft multiplied by this force. Now what else you need? You need the sigma by y equal to m by I. Now you know the value of m. You know the value of sigma. It has been given in question as 19 newton per meter mm square. Now cross section I already showed you here. In this picture also you can see the cross section how it will look. So this cross section will look like something this. Now you need relation between B and D. So this relation has been given as 4:1. So what is the ratio width to thickness? Your width is D and your thickness is B. So that has been given as 4:1. Means your this depth, this width is equal to 4 times of your thickness. So and what will be the value of Y? Y will be equal to D by 2. Okay. So this all information you need know, and value of I you also know. So directly putting this value in this formula, you can calculate the value of what they are asking, the width of the standard. So width is what? This value of D. So what you can, you put all this value and your value of D will come as 129.27 mm. Now you can directly put this value into your answer. Okay, so I hope this problem is clear. So this type of problems are completely design problem, where with the help of forces or speed you need to calculate the cross section. Here they can also ask the cross section area. So how you will calculate? Now you know the value of D, that is the width. So by this width you can calculate this thickness, and cross section area will be equal to B into D. So directly you can know the cross section area. Means in place of width they can also ask to calculate the area. So let's move towards the second question. This is question 2009 question. Okay, this question I will not solve. You solve this question and comment in the comment box. I will just give you one hint. So this time what they are asking, the cross sectional area. So you know the general equation, that is sigma by y equal to m by I. So do I know the value of m? Yes, this has been given as 120. So I will put directly. So cross section they have given. So what will be my cross section? Suppose this is my cross section where this thickness is D and the width is D. So the ratio has been given 3:1. So they are not giving whether they are giving B ratio D or D ratio B. So by general, since I can see here this depth is higher, means D by B that will be equal to 3:1, because my this depth will be equal to 3 times of thickness. So directly now I can take as D equal to 3 times B. I Q value, what is the value of I? That is B D cube by 12. So now I can replace this value of D as value of B. Okay, now value of Y will be, Y is D by 2. So now I know this value also. And what is the value of sigma? Sigma has been given here, 8×10⁻⁷ newton per meter square. So you need to calculate any value D or B, and using this relation you can calculate value of B. And they are asking cross sectional area in mm square. So here what your value will you will get, that will be in meter. So you need to calculate into mm, and then you multiply B into D. So I think you will get answer as B. So okay, this type of problems are not coming every year, but I think in the coming year such type of problem will appear in the exam. So I thought to make one small video regarding this. So these are the only two problems which have come in the previous year. So in future, if any problem comes related to bending, here in this also they have given the bending moment. So you need to directly apply this equation and this cross section area, and simply you can get the answer. So I think this video will help you to solve such type of problem. In the future video, we will also try to cover the hitch system, because many people are demanding to make video on the forces acting or tillage implement on the hitch system. So I showed you the table, so don't worry much about this, and we will complete that. Please do like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching.